Yes, yes, we can see your screen. I started recording.
Okay, you can start. Ida, can you hear us? You can start the
recording. Okay, pausing the slideshow. Okay, should I start?
Yeah.
Good morning, everyone. Today I'm presenting about a disease called Lyme disease. So what is Lyme disease? This is an infection due to a bacteria called Spirochete bacteria. The species are Borrelia burgdorferi, which is native to North America, and Borrelia jaremii and Borrelia abcellii, which is native to Europe and Asia. This infection is transmitted by exotic tick. The tick itself is infected with the Borrelia bacteria after biting a small rodent such as mouse or rat, or after feeding an infected deer or bird. Lyme disease is transmitted to humans by a bite from an infected tick. The tick has to be present on the skin for at least 36 hours to transmit the infection. Lyme disease was first recognized in the town of Old Lyme, Connecticut in 1975. It is the most common tick-borne illness in Europe and the United States. But in India, it is extremely rare, like fewer than 5,000 cases per year in India is seen, in North. Most people with Lyme disease were bitten by immature ticks called minks. These tiny ticks are very difficult to see. They feed during the spring and summer. Adult ticks also carry the bacteria, but they are easier to see and can be removed before transmitting the infection. And this is an adult tick, which you can see in the picture. Is Lyme disease contagious? There is no evidence that Lyme disease is contagious between people. Also, according to Centers of Disease Control and Prevention, Trust Reports, pregnant women can transmit the disease to their fetus through their breast milk. These bacteria are found in body fluids, but there is no evidence that Lyme disease can be spread to another person through sneezing, coughing, or kissing. There is also no evidence that Lyme disease can be sexually transmitted or transmitted through a blood transfusion. Lyme disease stages. Lyme disease can occur in three stages: early localized, early disseminated, and late disseminated. The symptoms you experience will depend on which stage the disease is in. The progression of Lyme disease can vary by individual. Some people who have it don't go through all three stages. Stage one, early localized disease. Symptoms of Lyme disease usually start 1 to 2 weeks after the tick bite in this stage. One of the earliest signs of disease is a bull's eye rash. The rash occurs at the site of the tick bite, usually, but not always, as a central red spot, surrounded by a clear spot with an area of redness at the edge. It may be warm to the touch, but it's not painful at the present age. This rash will gradually fade in most people. The formal name for this rash is erythema migrans. Some people have a rash that's solid red, while people with dark complexion may have a rash that resembles a bruise. The rash occurs with or without systemic viral or flu-like symptoms. Other symptoms commonly seen in this stage of Lyme disease include chills, fever, enlarged lymph nodes, sore throat, fatigue, muscle ache, and headaches. Stage 2, or early disseminated Lyme disease. Usually occurs several weeks to months after the tick bite. You will have a general feeling of being unwell, and a rash may appear in area other than the tick bite. This stage of the disease is primarily characterized by evidence of systemic infection, which means infection has spread throughout the body, including to other organs. Symptoms can include multiple erythema multiform lesions, disturbance in heart rhythm, which can be caused by Lyme carditis, neurologic conditions such as numbness, tingling, facial and cranial nerve pulses, and meningitis. And this is late disseminated Lyme disease. These fish occur when infection hasn't been treated in stage 1 and 2. Stage 3 can occur months or years after the tick bite, and this stage is characterized by arthritis of one or more large joints, brain disorder such as encephalopathy, which can cause short-term memory loss, difficulty concentrating, mental fogginess, problems with following conversation, and sleep disturbance, numbness in the arms, legs, hands, or feet. The pathophysiology of Borrelia burgdorferi enters the skin at the site of the tick bite, and after 3 to 32 days, the organism migrates locally in the skin around the bite, spread via the lymphatics to cause regional adenopathy or disseminate in blood to organs or other skin sites. And initially, an inflammatory reaction, erythema maculum, occurs before sufficient antibody response to infection. For Lyme disease diagnosis, it is diagnosed based on symptoms, physical findings, example rash, and possibility of exposure to infected ticks. Healthcare provider will perform a physical exam to look for the presence of a rash or other symptoms characteristic of Lyme disease. Testing during early localized infection is not recommended, but blood tests are most reliable a few weeks after the initial infection. When antibodies are present, and healthcare providers may order the following test. Enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. It is used to detect antibodies against burgdorferi. Western blood, it is also used to confirm a positive ELISA test. It checks for the presence of antibodies to detect burgdorferi. Polymerase chain reaction, PCR, trusted source, is used to evaluate people with persistent Lyme arthritis or nervous system symptoms. It is performed on joint fluids or cerebrospinal fluid. PCR testing on CSF or for diagnosis of Lyme disease is not routinely recommended due to low sensitivity. A negative test doesn't rule out the diagnosis. In contrast, most people will have positive PCR results in joint fluid if tested prior to antibiotic therapy. For Lyme disease prevention, you can decrease risk of getting Lyme disease with some simple precautions like cover up, use insect repellents, check cover with children and pets for ticks, remove a tick as soon as possible with tweezers, and if there are tick bites, you should use an antibody prophylactic treatment, and that's normally doxycycline and usually used within 72 hours of a tick bite, which is contraindicated during pregnancy, lactation, and children under age of 3. Treatments. People treated with appropriate antibiotics in early stage of Lyme disease usually recover rapidly and completely. Antibiotics commonly used for oral treatment include doxycycline, amoxicillin, or ceftriaxone. People with certain neurological or cardiac form of illness may require intravenous treatment with antibiotics such as ceftriaxone or penicillin. Treatment regimen listed in following table are for localized Lyme disease. These regimens are guidelines only and may need to be adjusted depending on a person's age, medical history, underlying health condition, pregnancy, or allergies. For adults, doxycycline 100 mg twice per day orally for 10 to 21 days. Ceftriaxone 500 mg twice per day orally for 14 to 21 days. Amoxicillin 500 mg 3 times per day orally for 14 to 21 days. And for children, amoxicillin 50 mg per kg per day orally, which is divided into 3 doses for 14 to 21 days. Doxycycline 4.4 mg per kg per day orally divided into 2 doses for 10 to 21 days. And ceftriaxone 30 mg per kg per day divided into 2 doses for 14 to 21 days. For people intolerant of amoxicillin, doxycycline, and ceftriaxone, the mark-release azithromycin, clarithromycin, or erythromycin may be used. Although they have a lower efficacy, people treated with macrolides should be closely monitored to ensure that symptoms resolve. The National Institute of Health has funded several studies on the treatment of Lyme disease that show most people recovered when treated within a few weeks of antibiotics taken by mouth. In a small percentage of cases, symptoms such as fatigue and muscle ache can last for more than 6 months. This condition is known as post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome, although it's often called chronic Lyme disease. And here is a case of a 10-year-old boy presented with a 3-day history of sudden appearance of a painful brownish raised lesion over the back of his left leg, associated with surrounding redness, which was increasing progressively. The child didn't have fever or any other systemic complaints. He gave a history of visit to a nearby forest a few days before the appearance of the lesion. On examination, there was an erythematous annular plug on the back of the left lower leg, approximately 6 to 5 centimeters in size, with a central brownish fluid filled blister, which you can see in the picture. The patient was subjected to baseline investigations, including complete hemogram with peripheral blood smear, which was found to be normal. Serology for Borrelia burgdorferi antigen was done with enzyme immunoassay technique. Immunoglobulin M was raised at 4.4. The normal is less than 0.9, whereas immunoglobulin G was found to be normal, which was indicative of acute infection. Western blood couldn't be performed due to financial constraints. Biopsy from the active margin was of the lesion showed moderate revascular lymphocytic infiltrate with a focus on spongiosis, with papillary dermis showing extravasation of red blood cells. Treatment was initiated immediately with doxycycline 100 mg tablets twice daily along with other symptomatic therapies. After 1 week of treatment, the lesion didn't progress beyond the initial size, and there was decrease in the initial size, erythema, and induration. At 2 weeks, there was a further improvement in the above mentioned features associated with exfoliation of the skin, which you can see in figure 4A. The medication were continued for a total of 3 weeks, resulting in clinical resolution of the lesion. And if you are treated for Lyme disease with antibiotics, but continue to experience symptoms, it is referred to as post-Lyme disease syndrome or post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome. About 10 to 20% of people with Lyme disease experience this syndrome. According to a 2016 article published in the New England Journal of Medicine. And the cause is unknown. Post-Lyme disease syndrome can affect mobility and cognitive skills. Treatment is primarily focused on easing pain and discomfort. And most people recover, but it can take months or years.
Okay, so that was a good presentation. I like the way you put the case. Am I audible to all? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. So I like the way you put the case in between. So this is what I want expect from everyone, to come up with some case report about the presentation that will make us understand better. Yes, the selection of the disease was also good, pretty good, because it is not very common, and we don't know much about Lyme disease. And the reason we don't know is because it is not common in India, as she said rightly, and it is very common in UK and US. It was very common, and because of that, we saw the funding from NIH and many other agencies in its treatment. And the treatment is not very complicated, the antibiotic like doxycycline and penicillin. But what I would like to tell you is try to make the session more interactive. Okay? Though the only content will not work. If you have a great content, but if you don't make the session interesting and very like exciting to your audience, then even your great content fail to give impressive impression. Okay, so I was telling in the past that you can ask the question. You are free to ask the question to the audience. Maybe one or two questions, randomly pick up the name from the participant, and then ask. This will ensure us whether they are listening or not. If they are listening, how well they are listening to you, and so this will make the session more interactive. In between, let them allow them to ask questions if they have any doubt in the cases or in the presentation itself. So that will make presentation much nicer, okay, and much better to listen to what they want to tell. So overall, try to inculcate in the coming presentation from your end these things. Try to take care of these things so that things become easier.
You are not audible. I can't hear you.
You didn't hear me anything.
Can you repeat, please?
Yeah, just give me the control. Don't touch your mouse. Let me.
Okay.
Anybody have any questions from my presentation? Yeah.
No,
there's
no
questions.
Any vaccine was made, approved for this Lyme disease?
Hello.
Any vaccine was approved for this?
I think there was a vaccine before, but now it's discontinued. I haven't checked why, but
this is relevant because we saw most of the tests are dependent on antibody, okay, PCR, Western blot. So this is a relevant question, I feel. So we should look into this whether there is an. Any other questions to Ada? No questions? Okay. Okay. Who is this first? There's no next presentation, no?